I'm Hugh Brown. I'm here at the Data Science Immersive at Galvanize in Denver. Been here for the last 13 weeks, getting up to speed on data science. I come to this with a long career in software development. I've worked with large data projects for a long period of time, large bodies of code, working in many, many languages. For my Capstone project here in at Galvanize, I worked on bit.ly data that captured the Germanwings crash of March 24th, 2015. And if you're not familiar with it, basically there was a co-pilot who shockingly locked the co-pilot or the pilot out of the cockpit, and intentionally crashed the plane. And this information wasn't initially known. It was found by investigators over a period of days, and the story broke gradually. And so the focus of my project was to back out the topics and the information and show you that you could rediscover the story from the data, and that essentially the data was coherent with what came out in the media. So bit.ly, a company which does URL shortening, provided me with a lot of data over the period of March 25th to March 27th. I had the top 10 minutes of each of 72 hours. So, and each of those was a zipped up file which, when uncompressed, turned into a gig. So I had like 72 gig of data. I was working with Python on AWS with MongoDB because it was the best risk-managed approach to working with the data. So I spent a lot of time cleaning the data, throwing out a lot of stuff which had to do with advertising and which was essentially unrelated to my story, and I pared it down to around 25,000 documents on which I ended up doing topic modeling. The topics were in fact largely siloed on each language that I was looking at, and the languages that my data came in were Danish, English, French, German, Spanish, Dutch, Russian. There's a lot of data in different languages. But apart from the single topic in each language, there was also kind of a secondary topic from which you could get some sort of distinctions. A couple of the interesting things which came out of it were that you could clearly see that the focus in the German stories was much more on family, on the investigation, on the relatives, and had a different angle. And on the American side, the leading topic that came out of the data was an interest in the co-pilot and the mental health issues associated with him, and the fact that he hid his health records. As I was saying earlier, the information came out over a period of time, and you could clearly see spikes in the data traffic as topics came out. And if you looked at those topics, you could see that they were actually related to specific stories which came out on those days, typically in those languages, although predominantly in English. The other obvious things that you could back out of it were that there was information which developed over time zones. You know, while America's sleeping, there isn't as much interest, but as soon as the United States wakes up on the East Coast, there's interest in this story, and the new developments get new traffic. So largely the data shows a coherence with what I know from the media, and you can see both of those in parallel. A lot of the value in the project was in the fact that there was a large amount of data, and ordinarily if I were doing this like for a professional job, I would have used a slightly different tool set. I probably would have gone for Spark with AWS, but my lack of deep familiarity with the tools meant that it was necessary to risk manage the project properly and to use the tools I was most familiar with in the near term. But that still meant that I ended up using Amazon Web Services, which is a valuable tool set for industry. I would have preferred to work with supervised data, but I didn't have supervised data. I was unsupervised learning. The main thing that I learned out of it was how important it is to have a good data pipeline and to manage the information that you extract from it and the way you manipulate it so that you can recreate it reliably. At times, I had to go back and redo things so that I had a repeatable kind of pipeline on the data. And that was really the most important thing to come out of it. As a matter of fact, I tried a lot of different ways to get industry data, and going with Bitly was the best approach.